This feeling in my bones, so good. I never felt this strong. You got me feeling so good, and you know that I would. You got me feeling so good, and you know that I would. You got me feeling so good, and you know that I.
For once, I've got nothing to say. In the city of brotherly love, the home of extreme, we'll let the carnage do all the talking. WWE Extreme Rules.
Randy Orton tore his orange corduroys. Randy Orton tore his orange corduroys. Sabu sued the Uso shoe store. Sabu sued the Uso shoe store. Batista teased the teenage barista. Batista teased the teenage barista. La 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 la.
True.
Humana, humana,
hey.
Humana. Yeah,
hey.
Yeah. Hey, hey, what's up, Matt?
What are you doing?
Well, I'm guest hosting The Bump today. I'm happy to be back, and I was doing my vocal warm-ups to get ready for the show.
Okay, no Kayla, so we appreciate you being here with us. Kayla. It's a massive show today, and I don't know if you noticed, like, the last couple weeks have kind of got off the rails. KO, Johnny Gargano,
yeah.
Judgment Day's here today.
Not a problem. You won't have to worry about that. I got it taken
Thanks,
care
buddy.
Of.
Thanks, buddy. Hey. Yes? Say that to Dom?
What'd she say to Dom?
She whispered for a reason.
I couldn't hear. I just thought we could share as the guest.
Nope. We're gonna leave it, okay? We're just
Yeah, we should leave it. I think we should leave it.
I think that's a
good idea.
The Judgment Day is here today on WWE's The Bump, and we should go start the show.
We should definitely go start the show. All right, see you guys very shortly.
Judgment Day.
See you.
Bye. Dude, like, we're not even starting.
I wanted to know what she said, man. I didn't think it was a big deal.
Last week, they had fun with us. I do not want to get beat up by them. They don't care.
I am a professional, okay?
I know. You can defend yourself. I don't do this. Let's sit.
You won't get hurt.
Thank you. Hello, everybody, and welcome to WWE's The Bump. I'm Matt Camp, and my guest host, co-host for today is Drew Gulak.
Yeah.
Drew. Glad to have you,
dude.
Here.
I'm so pumped to be back here at The Bump, man. I had so much fun last time with you guys, and this is just a huge opportunity for myself. So thank you so much.
Thank you for being with us. We have a lot to get to. You see who's here, but Ryan, a lot of social sentiment. Hopefully, the people are on our side after what just happened.
Very much so. They're also curious about your vocal warm-ups. Maybe we can talk about that after the fact.
Just some simple exercises.
Yeah, they're casual stuff. And for more casual stuff, or for in-depth, whatever you want, hashtag WWE The Bump. Get in the conversation on the YouTube chat, which I've been keeping eyes on already. Ed Marie says he loves the Judgment Day. Already a ton of Poppy references from Chris, Rojas, many, many others. And hashtag it across all those platforms, including YouTube chat, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, for questions, comments, other vocal warm-up suggestions, and, you know, whisper thoughts, anything across the board. Guys, let's have fun.
We're going to get to all of it today. Obviously, the Judgment Day will be joining us. We're very excited to have Finn, Rhea, and Damian Priest all here in Stamford for the very first time. We'll get to all of that. But let's take you back to last week. We also went down on Friday night SmackDown. Logan Paul had a big announcement. He would confront most of the Bloodline, and Paul Heyman and him would go back and forth, and that would lead to a press conference that took place the very next day in Las Vegas. The entire Bloodline, including the undisputed WWE Universal Champion Roman Reigns, was there. A challenge was laid out, and no surprise, it got heated.
Yeah.
This man has over 30 million followers, and what he's doing right now is he's bringing them all to his tribal chief. Because before this happened, he was in a good place with the Bloodline as well, because we're gonna allow him to do what he's been doing. Logan, you could be on any show that I main event for the rest of my career. I appreciate you and the following that you bring. You can be the third match on any card any single day. You understand me? But the fact that he wants to step up to the main event, ladies and gentlemen, let me teach you a little lesson here. You need to crawl before you walk. Walk before you run. And once you've figured out how to run, then maybe one day you'll be able to fly with the tribal chief.
Just like I said on my podcast, Crown Jewel, November 5th, Saudi Arabia, is my match. Roman Reigns, you are the head of the table. But brother, in every industry I ever do, I am the table. And Roman Reigns will acknowledge me on November 5th.
Logan Paul, Drew, right there, obviously quoting and only quoting Metallica. They're saying, I am the table, letting Roman Reigns know he's not worried, he is not afraid, and we are going to see these two clash And I think they got to be saying this about 3 weeks ago, for the undisputed WWE Universal Championship at Crown Jewel in about a month, a little over that, I should say, about 2 months away, Roman Reigns defending against Logan Paul. Drew, do you believe in that idea of it only takes one shot?
I mean, if, as a competitor, of course, I believe that, you know, you can get lucky. You can absolutely get lucky. We've heard this before when it comes to the Tribal Chief Roman Reigns, with people saying they just need to get lucky. And it just goes to show you that he is on a completely different level now. It is, as a peer to him, it is inspiring to me. As far as Logan Paul goes, I mean, my fellow wise man Paul Heyman said it best. He compared it to his match with, or his fight with Floyd Mayweather.
Which he survived. Didn't get knocked down.
He didn't get knocked down, but it's like, man, the odds were not in his favor.
No, not at all. He survived it. Survival will not beat Roman Reigns. He's going to get knocked down a lot of times against Roman Reigns.
He's going to be tested more than he's ever been tested in his life. You know, this is WWE. This is professional wrestling. It is not like anything else. I respect everyone who steps foot in that ring. But Logan Paul, best of luck to you, sir.
And a lot of people certainly had major reaction to that. Some people are saying, Logan, good luck. Other people are saying, Logan, this is your opportunity. Ryan, what are you hearing out there?
We're going to cover that entire gamut right now. Yeah, no surprise that Logan Paul gets announced for an undisputed WWE Universal title match and that there's a lot of strong opinions. Logan would be the first to say he's the underdog coming into this, but people like LJ here are riding with Logan. Logan Paul with Superman punches, a spear to Roman, and then standing over him shouting, acknowledge me to Roman, is going to be class. Now, that's LJ's opinion. LJ is just one man. Margaret, an unabashed Roman supporter, says, no way, not only can Logan Paul not defeat Roman Reigns, Margaret believes nobody can beat Roman Reigns, and Margaret has been correct for the better part of 2 years now. With all of that said, though, Vladimir here says, Logan Paul versus Roman Reigns for the undisputed Universal Championship is something I never thought I'd see. Me neither, Vlad. But honestly, I can't wait for it. I think it's going to be an entertaining match. Logan Paul has showed up and showed out in every single match he has had in WWE so far. Had an incredible frog splash at SummerSlam, unlike I've ever seen. We have a lot to look forward to at Crown Jewel. But Matt, we also have a lot to look forward to at Extreme Rules.
Absolutely. No doubt about that. Extreme Rules. Drew will talk all about Philadelphia and what it means to Extreme Rules. But we know what's going down based on Monday Night Raw. If that happens at Extreme Rules, I'll be really excited. But the United States Championship was on the line. Two men battling to be the face of Monday Night Raw. The champion, the almighty Bobby Lashley and Seth freaking Rollins. And they have only had a handful of matches. See the ref kind of get taken out here for a second. Seth's going to use some underhanded tactic, or underfoot, if you will. But we know what's been going on between Seth and Matt Riddle. And Matt wanted to ruin this for Seth. But he would stop short. He would say, listen, bro, I'm not going after you just yet. But, of course, Bobby Lashley only needed those few seconds, that hit stick spear, gonna put Seth down, and a successful title defense for Bobby Lashley. However, that would lead us to later on in the night. It would be Matt Riddle teaming with Rey Mysterio, shades of maybe Rey and RVD back in the day. And Seth would get involved in this one as they were taking on our guest today, the Judgment Day. Rey is a great teammate, as we know. His son may not agree, because right there, he gave him a chance to smack him across the face like Ken Shamrock in The Rock with a chair. He wouldn't take it, but that hesitation, we saw it happen earlier in the night with Bobby Lashley and Seth. It happened here with Rey and the Judgment Day. That sling blade there from Rey. This massive South of Heaven chokeslam is going to put Rey down. And as we have seen a lot over the last month, a coup de grace from Finn Balor is going to give the Judgment Day a very big victory.
You know what? You want a rematch? You name the time. You name the place. I'll wreck you, pal. Come on, let's go.
Extreme Rules. Fight Pit.
Come on,
bro. Fight Pit.
You're on. You're on, Riddle. I'm going to wreck you in your own backyard. You're a dead man, pal.
At each other's throats all Monday night, which means we're going somewhere we haven't gone in a while. The Fight Pit is back, and the Fight Pit will make its premium live event debut at Extreme Rules. Matt Riddle versus Seth freaking Rollins in Philadelphia. Drew, you're the perfect man to talk to about this one. Does this favor Matt Riddle in a very big way?
this match absolutely favors Matt Riddle in a very big way. I'd take nothing away from Seth Rollins. He's been in every kind of stipulation under the sun. You know, no stranger to cages, for sure.
Sure.
Had some very successful times, some very not so successful times, but he's been through it all. Matt, however, is a trained fighter. The name of this match is The Fight Pit.
Right.
Okay? This favors him immensely. Not to mention, he was in the very first one against Timothy Thatcher,
that's right,
a man who I know very well, who created this match. Yeah, Matt's been here before. He knows the kind of pressure this brings. You know, the Fight Pit, walled off cage, no ropes to work with here. There's a platform above, which invites all sorts of chaos, as you know. And this match is super personal, man.
Absolutely. That's the other part of it. It's super personal. But I think we'll step away from that in a second because, Ryan, people heard Fight Pit, and it lit Twitter on fire, you and I included.
Absolutely. I mean, I just love watching people fight. It's really cool. And yeah, I mean, excitement, I think, was definitely the watchword after this got announced. We're going to see this first tweet here from Gutterball. Gary Payton was all of us here. I'd like to see Gary Payton in the Fight Pit, quite frankly. But we're going to get Matt Riddle and Seth Rollins, and it's going to be a sight to behold. We got an old school GIF here just with Josh, just super excited for fun. I love how excited we all get to watch two people go into the Fight Pit. But you know what? We are. And then KC here says, Fight Pit, ? And then all caps, Fight Pit, ! That is how I feel. That's how all of us feel. This is as personal a rivalry as we have had in WWE in a very, very, very long time. No better setting, no better atmosphere than the Fight Pit. Extreme Rules, Philadelphia, home of the extreme. Let's go.
We'll talk more about that coming up in just a little bit. But right now, before we bring on our first guest, we're going to talk to everyone about something that is very near and dear to everyone's hearts here in WWE. We want to remind everyone to get involved and team up to help fight pediatric cancer by making a donation seen here or go to WWE's community page or the V Foundation's website. Through both the V Foundation and Connor's Cure, the WWE is committed to raising awareness for cancer research and continuing to provide funds that support cutting-edge research at pediatric cancer facilities around the world, while also advocating for increased public funding for pediatric cancer research in the United States. Our own Byron Saxton sat down with Connor Mihalik's dad, Steve Mihalik, and Dana Warrior in this exclusive interview.
Beep, beep. Working.
My name's King Crusher.
I'm 7 years old.
I'm working to take down cancer. You gonna join me?
Thanks.
I did that on purpose.
Of course, you can get involved right here, as you can see, not only in the month of September, but all year long. We'll catch more of that actual interview next week here right on WWE's The Bump. Drew, always important. We have our platform. You see our pins. Yeah. But being able to have this platform sure means a lot to you as well.
Just getting the chance to be a WWE superstar and raise awareness for certain causes. You know, Connor's Cure is very near and dear to all our hearts here at WWE. We're very proud of the work that we've done. So we appreciate the support from all of the WWE universe in our endeavor to give back.
No doubt about it. Like I said, not only in the month of September, but all year long. Be aware of this, contribute to this, and be thinking about this. Now, obviously, we have some guests standing by. The Judgment Day will be joining us in a matter of minutes. But, Drew, I believe you had some involvement or we worked on something yesterday because you're a man of many talents and hats.
Yes, I do wear many hats. Thank you, Matt. And one of the hats I wear quite often, I might add, is that of a trainer and a coach. You know, many people might be familiar with my coaching abilities and giving them a nice tutorial here and there, you might say. So I did us all a very, very nice thing. I think if you recall.
Yesterday.
Yes. We did something very cool. And right now, I think we're going to throw to that segment. Is that what's going
to
happen?
Throw
okay. So, yeah, I'm being told right now. Yep, we do have it ready. Okay. Take it away, Drew.
Thank you, Drew. And we are here backstage at The Bump, ready to break it down. I'm here with my boys, Matt.
Yeah.
Boom, I'm here with my boy, Ryan. We are here in front of this giant screen. And what are we going to do?
Well, we want you to break some things
break
down. This is
break it down.
Yeah. This is a John Madden-esque, a Bobby the Brain Heenan brain scan-esque, or whatever you want to call it.
I'll call it the Bobby Heenan brain scan 2.0. Shout out to John Madden, RIP. Bobby Heenan, RIP. This is a tribute to you guys. Coach Drew Gulak here. Got my coaching hat for
you. Right, because you wear many hats or visors here in WWE.
I do wear a lot of hats.
So we want to, while you're hosting right now, in the future, we'd like you to break something down. We're going to start with one of our guests who is watching, obviously, in the future.
Sure.
Finn Balor, last week on Monday Night Raw, hit this unbelievable, brutal coup de grace right there on the Hall of Famer edge. Oh, you haven't seen this?
No, I haven't seen this clip yet.
That's new?
All right, let's break this down.
I mean, almost literally.
Yeah. As Finn is breaking down Edge's knee. This right here, gentlemen, is sadly the key. Okay, that is a steel folding chair.
It is.
When these are brought into play, they should be banned from the arenas, in my opinion, at this point.
No chairs in the arena.
This wasn't a chairs match.
Right.
Why are they wearing their chairs?
Well, the match is over at this point.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay, fair enough. Sorry.
If they weren't there in the first place.
Right. Standing room only.
You know what? I digress, though. It could have been worse. He could have grabbed something else. Anyway, this creates a fulcrum, right, which is leverage here. And I'd say, even though Edge is very big, very strong human, I'd say that works against his favor, right? Because what you have here is all of that force coming straight down. Coming straight down on that MCL tear,
yes.
I believe you called
MCL
it.
MCL sprain, yes.
Oh, my gosh.
Great, too. This is Rhea Ripley in the future. She'll be watching. It's the Riptide.
Okay.
This is impressive.
Here we got Rhea Ripley against Doudrop here. Weight class difference.
Maybe her biggest Riptide ever.
Yes, yes. Very impressive. Very, very impressive maneuver. I want you to look here, okay? That is the height of Doudrop's hips in this position, okay? And down here, you have the leverage of Rhea's hips. So what happened was she was able to get her hips underneath her opponent's hips and then lift. Okay, when you do that, you can throw pretty much anyone, regardless of their size, to a degree. And she's able to do this kind of a lift right here. And if you look, you know, referee here,
Shocked.
Tom Bennett, just blown away. He's seen thousands of matches.
Yeah,
right?
Any Riptides even.
And he is so surprised. He is so surprised. Look at this. So surprised.
Okay. Surprise cat.
Yeah, it's like a surprised kitty cat. There we go. That's what he's doing. Okay? There he is.
Maybe the most historical figure outside of yourself in Philadelphia.
Okay.
Is Ben Franklin.
Oh, sure, yeah, okay.
And this is history, this is science.
Yeah, all right.
Is there more to this that we don't know about?
What many people don't realize, right? And I want to draw your attention from up here to right here. This gentleman right here, right? The great, great, great grandfather of Carl Gotch.
Really?
One of the most iconic professional wrestlers of all time.
Basically started the thing, yeah.
Has heritage descending directly from this artistic representation of Benjamin Franklin discovering electricity. This is not a painting of Ben Franklin discovering electricity, no. This is a painting of the very first fight pit match.
What?
Yes, hear me out here, okay? So, this painting, right, discovering electricity comes from the?
Sky.
The sky, yeah. Good. So we're up here in the sky, that area, right, guys?
Right.
Okay. Now, he was monitoring how the electricity from the clouds in the form of lightning gets to the
ground.
Ground, right. Very good, guys. Very good. So it has to travel down to this general area here.
Sure.
Okay? Now, the waves follow a pattern and move in degrees.
Oh.
It moves from the sky to the ground. From the sky to the ground. From the sky to the ground. And more directly, those lines go straight down, gentlemen.
Come on now.
And what we have right here is the very first fight pit match. Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, late 1700s, Ben Franklin, Carl Gotch's great, great, great grandfather.
And now, Matt Riddle and Seth freaking Rollins.
Oh, yeah.
Hopefully we're watching, because I learned a bunch right there about the
fight. In Philadelphia, the next fight pit match.
It just makes sense, guys.
And I think we'll stay in Philadelphia.
Oh, okay.
Because you need to prepare for matches with fuel.
My people.
And how could you fuel up the right
way?
Right there.
Oh, yeah!
What are we looking at here?
Yeah, baby! You know what this is! You guys, totally, look at this. Look at this right here. This is not just a cheesesteak, gentlemen. Oh my gosh, this is the cheesesteak. This is a Philadelphia legend right here. You want to talk about gritty? I'm talking about D'Alessandro.
First place ever at a cheesesteak.
Yo, cuz, let's
first
go up
place.
To D'Alessandro's, get that whiz wit, because that's what this is. This is a whiz wit. The most important ingredient of them all.
Bread.
knew it.
I knew it.
My man, it is nothing without the bread, okay?
Binds it all together.
It binds it all together. Okay, usually these are Sarcone's rolls, which is straight from over the bridge in Jersey.
That's right.
That bread, oh my gosh, that looks so good.
Down the street from the bread.
They don't make them like this anywhere else in the world, gentlemen. But the thing that makes this a D'Alessandro's cheesesteak is simply this right here. They stuff this thing to the brim.
They cut the bread out a little bit.
They might scoop a little of that bread out there because they load this thing with just steak and cheese and onions. Oh my gosh, my mouth is watering just thinking about this here. Guys, you just made my day, yeah! Cheesesteak, break it down. Break down that cheesesteak, yes!
I think we're good. You want to throw it back to yourself?
Oh my gosh. Me, throwing it back to you, from me. Keep it going, you're doing a great job.
Thanks, Drew. Great job.
Thanks. I was dressed, I thought, for a physical workout. Instead, you nourished our brains, which I really appreciated.
I got a physical workout.
Well, so you did.
I nourished your brain.
That was about 6 minutes of 90 minutes that you talked to us out there.
Wow.
So we did really learn a lot yesterday.
You know, time just flies when you're having fun.
It did. And I had a ton of fun. And hopefully the rest of this program will be fun because it's time to get to our guest right now.
Oh,
hopefully
okay.
It's going to go better than it did when we began the show.
It's fine.
They have absolutely run roughshod over Monday Night Raw, including Rey Mysterio. They've taken out Edge. They have a new family member in Dominic Mysterio, and they right now are as dominant as can be. We welcome to the show right now Finn Balor, Rhea Ripley, and Damian Priest for the first time here in the studio. This is the Judgment Day. Welcome, welcome.
Welcome, guys.
Welcome. Hey, I got it. Nope.
Hey.
Maybe.
Good to see ya.
Finn?
What's up, brother?
Pleasure.
How are you?
Thanks for coming in.
Yeah.
All right.
That's enough.
Yeah.
Hi. Just go across the front of your mate.
Please.
It's your day.
This is my seat, right?
Judgment Day here in Stanford.
Yeah, great to have you guys. Great to see you.
I know, right?
I got to ask you right away. You saw Drew's breakdowns. What'd you think of Finn? You did some damage last week.
Be honest. It's okay.
I want to be honest.
Yeah.
I want to say that I'm extremely impressed with how well you speak and how well you conduct yourself on this show. And I don't understand why you are still wrestling. Because you don't do that very well at all. But you do this extremely well. So if I was to give you some advice, I would say stick to what you're good at. And perhaps this would be more the lane that you should stay in up here in Stanford and away from Raw and SmackDown and NXT.
I always appreciate your advice. I didn't have you pegged as someone who was intimidated by my wrestling ability on the roster. But hey, you know, like, thank you so much. As always, thank you. It's appreciated.
We thank you all for being here, and Drew's going to do his best here today. Speaking of Raw, quite an eventful night for all three of you. Let's start with the massive victory over Matt Riddle and Rey Mysterio between this. Damian, you putting Riddle down. We know what's coming up this Monday with you two getting in the ring. I'll start right now. What is this going to mean to you? We saw what went down on Monday. You have dominated Rey Mysterio. and you two together taking advantage. This is a cohesive family, a unit, and it was great enough here to get you this victory. But, Damian, we know what's coming. Next week, it's you and Riddle. What does that mean to you, knowing how far back you guys go?
Yeah, well, for me, whatever the past is just that past. You know, this is the new bond. This is the new family. So, come Monday, I mean, it's not necessarily about what it means to me pertaining to the past. It's just another person to fall to the Judgment Day. That's it. That's all that matters.
The friendship's gone, as you're telling me that?
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough.
You know what? We gave an opportunity, explained it to him, but obviously he's a little too much oxygen up here. He doesn't get it.
Okay, that's what it is.
Yeah.
I heard it can do that.
Oh, okay.
Right.
Lots of oxygen. What kind of opportunity did you guys exactly offer to Mr. Riddle, out of curiosity?
A spot. A spot in history, a spot for his legacy, a spot in the Judgment Day. Mm. And, well, he chose to, to think that his rivalry with Seth is more important. Cool, good luck, because it's worked out so good so far, right? So, you know, look at Dom. main eventing Raw against Edge. His first match after joining the Judgment Day. So that'll tell you what you need to know of what the Judgment Day can do for you. Hmm.
I feel like we've got a little bit of heat now or something. You're kind of giving me the eyes.
Which eyes?
Oh, eyes. Like you want to fight or something.
I mean.
Bump's just the name of the show.
If,
the name
if okay. you want to throw down.
No.
You know,
no,
I don't know.
Really?
Nope. We're good. Just co-hosting in the suit today. Keep it in the suit. I don't want to mess with anything.
You can keep a suit on.
Okay.
I'm happy to keep my suit on.
Please do. Ryan.
We'll reset here. Yeah.
Get in there.
Let's reset. Yeah. A lot happened on Monday for you three. Rhea, I'll kick this to you because maybe socially the biggest story was Dominik saying that you three were his new family. There was a lot of mommy and poppy talk. Rhea, I would be roasted on the internet if I did not ask you this first right out of the gate. Dominik is not here today, so obviously he cannot speak for himself. But can you elaborate on the nature of your relationship with Dominik over the past several weeks, him being now associated with you three?
Oh, man. I mean, wouldn't you like to know, first of all?
That's why I asked.
Wouldn't everyone like to know? But my relationship with Dominik is something that I keep with Dominik, okay? So I'm not going to go too in-depth with it, but I see a lot in him, like we all do. And I could see that Ray was taking advantage of him and not really giving them the spotlight that he really deserves, where he can blossom and just take charge of his own life. Like he said, he was in his father's shadow and he couldn't get out. So we gave him that opportunity. As for the mommy and papi stuff, I love every single aspect of that. I called myself Puppy before just to sort of get under his skin and get through to him and also just make fun of Ray. Yeah. Where Dom gets what he wants, you know? If he wants mommy, it's mommy. If he wants Puppy, it's Puppy.
That almost leads perfectly into the next question, although maybe you just answered it because you did post this after the fact on Monday. And again, people are curious about this stuff. Mommy, Poppy, whatever you want to call me, Dom Dom going forward. So you're fine. Either or, interchangeable, right? You know?
Either or, as long as he knows that I'm one of them.
I think he there does. It feels like he does.
Yep.
I actually really appreciate what you're doing for Dominik. I think it's very important, you know, in a young man's growth to have these kind of opportunities thrust, you know, into his pathway, so to speak. I think you've been a great mentor so far to him. I will say that it's very interesting to see it unfold live on TV so much the way it has recently. But yeah, I have to commend you.
It's not a, we shouldn't forget how much of a, not only a mentor Rhea has been, mm-hmm. but maybe a bad influence. That Priest has been, because obviously Dom is not here today. I think he's still struggling a little bit after the party Priest put him through on an initiation hard. Party on Monday night. So he's still got a little bit of learning to do.
Okay, so he needs a day.
And recovering. Yeah,
he needs a day.
Might be a couple of days.
You're the vets. You're the vets. You're out here. You're
everybody
making the red
has,
eyes. I get it.
Couple,
he'll be
know.
Good by Monday. Don't
fair
worry.
Fair enough. Yeah.
Everybody has a couple.
Dom, we. Best wishes or whatever, feel better, I guess. I want to talk about, though, Finn. Not only did these two have a busy Monday night, in addition to your victory, you had an encounter with AJ Styles, who you have been on the same side of at different points of your career, and especially this year. I'd like to take a look at that now.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up, AJ? We haven't spoken in a while. You faving me or something?
No, we haven't spoken since you joined Judgment Day and turned your back on me. But now we've talked, so that's over with, right?
Whoa. Only one of those things is true. Sure, I'm with the Judgment Day now, but I never turn my back on you. Has there ever been one moment in all the time that we've known each other that I have not had your back? Huh? No. You're right. You've had my back, I've had your back. So what, I joined Judgment Day, I don't know, and turned my back on the people that I love the most, just like Dominik did? I want no part of Judgment Day. AJ, dude, it's me, Finn. How long have we known each other? Dude, you know me. I come over here and I'm looking for my friend and I feel like you're looking for a fight. Are you looking for a fight, AJ? Nah, I know that you're not looking for a fight, dude. We're boys, come on. Give me a hold, man, give me some love. Hey, remember, the offer, still, stance.
I don't know if his tone changed, his look changed, whatever. Finn, did you get through what you wanted to AJ in that interaction?
I certainly hope so. You know, me and AJ have no beef. We've been friends a very long time. He's had my back a long time. I've had his back a long time. I don't see why anything should change.
Was that an open invitation? Is that what that is? Is that a standing invitation from all three of you, I guess I would ask?
Absolutely. The Judgment Day are a family. It's all four of us. It comes from Dom, too.
Okay. How would you feel about having AJ Styles standing alongside you?
I mean, I think I've said it before. I've been clear about that. AJ Styles, to me, it's a perfect fit. It makes sense. When we had issues with AJ, it all stemmed from Edge. If you really think about it, neither one of us ever had realistically an issue with him. It was all because of Edge. Now we got rid of that. There's no reason why we shouldn't work together. And if my boy over here is vouching for him, I don't need anything else.
That means a lot. I get it.
The same goes for Matt Riddle, too.
Yeah.
If you vouch for someone, I
Both
trust
of you
that.
Do, I'm sure.
If Rhea vouches for someone, I trust that. If Dom vouches for someone, I trust that.
So I'm noticing a pattern. Like, just from watching that clip back, you literally said the exact same thing to me like 2 seconds ago about wanting to start a fight. Are you learning your new mental jujitsu to try to like instigate people? Why would you want to fight AJ right now when you have so many other things to worry about?
First of all,
I went over to AJ and approached him as a friend.
Yeah.
There is some sarcasm in there, okay. And I know sarcasm. And I appreciate good sarcasm.
So from what I can tell,
you should listen to it for a second.
He gave him a hug.
It was a nice hug.
They were fine. I don't see you guys hugging. You know why? Because you keep giving him this look. I keep watching. You're giving him a look like you're asking for it.
You saw it too, right?
Yeah, I'm watching him. He keeps doing it.
I mean, I have many looks.
I switch the seats, maybe.
I'm not switching my seat.
I'm just checking.
I'm guest hosting this show.
Okay, there's...
A good guest host never backs down from a good guest.
Maybe in this case. Anyway, okay, let's...
Maybe we can switch Ryan and bring
Ryan
over
here.
Send him out over here. I am not afraid to ask the hard questions, okay?
Let me jump back in here. When Dom decided to betray his father at Clash of the Castle, I know you were all happy about that. It brought a lot of people back to the time when Eddie Guerrero did the exact same thing to Rey. As we take a look here, you go back to SmackDown quite a time ago. That clothesline was nearly identical to what we saw at Clash of the Castle from Dominic right here after that matchup. which you're enjoying. Go ahead, Damon. I'll start with you. What did you? Was this poetic justice, if you will?
First of all, I mean, you think out of all these years that have passed, he would have learned. And you know what? How did you word that? What did
poetic
he
justice.
No, what did he do to his father? He betrayed him.
He betrayed him.
I don't like that word.
I don't agree with that.
What's the word?
Be a better word.
He made a decision to step out of his shadow. He made a decision for his career, for his name, for his life. Like he decided, I want to do things for myself instead of living for somebody else.
Would you call it him coming to like a fork in the road in his career and his life? Is that a better way to put it?
He had a growth moment. He decided that he wants to be his own superstar. Not his dad's superstar. And that's all we wanted for him. That's all we want for anybody. I mean, that's why we say, hey, look, our doors are open. We're cool with everyone. Everyone seems to have a problem with the idea of loyalty to one another. Everybody has a problem with the idea of, hey, let's help each other become the biggest stars we can be. That's all we're trying to do.
I asked this to Rhea, though. Did you push him in that direction at all?
I didn't do anything.
Okay.
Nothing at all.
You can't push someone to betray their father.
No.
Could you set him in that direction?
No.
Okay.
No, the father pushes the child in every day of their life. I'm sure Dominic had been picked on and poked and jibed, and finally he had enough. And it's that simple.
Okay. Clearly worked out for him.
Absolutely. What I loved, to switch gears, what I loved about what just happened there when we showed that clip is you three started cracking up just like you did the night it happened. This has taken for, we'll show the GIF in a second. Funny. I mean, this will take, it took over the internet. Rhea, you made it your profile pic. Do you three love that we're gonna see it here now? I mean, this is now on the internet forever. I'll ask all three of you, Rhea, I'll start with you. I mean, like, this is now a meme for everything for the rest of time. How do you feel about that?
Oh, I love it. I love it so much. I could use it for everything. I love taking it to people on Twitter. So I can't wait to use this. As a weapon, pretty much.
Do you find it, like, versatile? You can use it in any situation whatsoever?
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. Definitely. Yeah.
That might sum the three of you up right now.
I mean, what's better than happiness?
And exactly.
That,
yeah.
That right there showed we're three happy people.
Exactly.
We want to share it.
Jovial.
Yeah.
I don't think people know that message, but I mean, that's pretty nice.
My lack of abs were hurting watching how much you were enjoying that in the midsection area there. I got to say, though, like... kind of disrespectful to take pleasure in that way. I think it was kind of obnoxious and intentional, which may have been your point, you know, if you're trying to be this manipulative kind of
or
crew,
we're just
this
happy
gang,
for somebody.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Kind of disrespectful.
Were you laughing at I'll ask the hard questions. Thank you. I'm the guest host.
Oh boy.
Man. Were you laughing at, you know, his upheaval, or were you laughing at the punishment that he brought?
First of all, that first word, I don't even know what it means, but the second one, punishment.
I know that one. Yeah.
What would I be laughing at someone's upheaval? Explain that to me exactly. What does that mean?
Were you laughing at him, like, taking control
of the
situation?
You said you were going to ask the hard questions, and you said, were you laughing at his
upheaval?
That might
have been too
hard. What does that mean?
Let me simplify it.
What does that mean? That is such a hard question.
Were you,
it doesn't make sense.
A little bit. Yeah.
You know what?
Same word.
You're right. It was a hard
randomly
question that doesn't make sense for you.
No.
You know, I'm from a very educated school in Philadelphia.
We have 24 minutes. I'd like you to last the next 24 minutes.
I can handle myself.
Not with three people sitting over there. I watch what they have done.
We're just joshing around.
Sorry.
We're fine. We're fine.
Ryan, please. I'm going to upheave this in a different direction. I'm switching gears. Because we've talked a lot about race so far, but Damian, I want to throw this to you. Because you had a massive match against Edge a few weeks back, which got incredible reviews. People loved it. You know, wrestling here saying it was an absolute banger. But what I thought was interesting, and I want this from your perspective, there was so much talk about it being in Toronto for Edge, and this for Edge. And obviously, we saw how it transpired that night. But for you, as a competitor, did that bother you that seemingly so many people were focused on Edge when it was the biggest night of your career just the same?
Well, that's expected, to be honest. You know, I think it used to bother me, but not anymore. Not since I found the common ground here with the Judgment Day. Like, we have a certain type of mentality. And for us, we know what we were walking into. I knew the reaction was going to be all about Edge, all about his coming back home after so many years. That's why I even said it, because I figured, you know what? That's all they're going to talk about anyway. Let me put it out there.
Yeah.
But I knew the moment is going to be for me. And it was.
Yeah.
You know, the end result of the actual match, not perfect, but we accomplished what we wanted.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The Judgment Day rose. And that's all we're going to keep doing, is the Judgment Day will continue to rise. And that was the point of it all. Granted, yeah, like I said, it didn't work out the way I wanted to, but who's on the show today and who's not? Where's Edge?
Yeah.
we said this on Monday. He's on that weird mountain of his.
The mountain of omnipotence.
Yeah.
That one.
And just like him, it makes no sense. So, you know, to each his own. But for me, we got what we wanted out of that night.
Right on.
It was your night in the end. Rhea, I want to go back to what's going on with Dom and the family dynamic. You said it's mommy or poppy, or as long as he knows it's one of those things. Is there an overall family dynamic where Dom fits in? Are these uncles? Are they brothers? How does that work?
I mean, we're all family.
That's it.
So, okay.
I mean, I don't know. What do you guys want to be called?
It's a feeling. It has nothing to do with blood and titles. It's about...
We all want the same thing.
Yeah, and the care for one another.
You're backing each other up.
We're here to help each other. That's what we do. That's why we're always there for each other's matches.
Exactly. If today is about Finn Balor, the three of us will be there for Finn Balor. If it's about Dominic, the three of us will be there for Dominic. That's how we roll. We don't roll one above the other.
Is that picture going to be like a Christmas card or a holiday card or anything like that? Could we be expecting to get one of those?
I see people already making it that, right?
Yeah, people have already made it into it.
That's Drew's not getting one from me. That's
no, Drew's not.
I celebrate Hanukkah. Thank you very much.
It's a holiday. I said anything. It could be non-denominational, Drew.
That's true.
I don't think you're getting one.
I would say, can I ask a follow-up question here, please, real quick? Okay, so you guys just talked about how you have each other's backs, but literally the man who has taken you under his wing, you're the man with the most tenure, sitting next to me here, turned his back on multiple people throughout his career. You know, the latest of which was Edge. And you guys happen to be roped into a part of that. And I would say that, you know, I'd be so bold to say manipulated, perhaps, perchance.
Whoa.
Into thinking I feel I'm being picked on
a little bit unfairly here. It wasn't just me who turned my back on Edge.
Well,
it was a group decision that we all came to an agreement on.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean...
So whatever narrative you're trying to push...
No narrative.
It's not
I just call it like I see it. You know, I just call it like I see it. If you guys had some kind of dealing behind Edge's back.
Has Miss Kayla on this show?
Yeah, I do, man. Right now I do, Finn.
You're very true. I'm having a great time, Matt. I don't know what you're talking about.
It's not, it's anyway. Finn, you did say that on Monday, the Judgment Day is more of a family to Dom than Ray ever was.
Did I?
Do you believe that?
I don't remember saying that.
You said, that came out and you said it and you said.
Say stuff, I don't know. Just for a moment.
More words? Okay. Yeah. I mean, he only grew up with him. That was his dad. He won his son's, you know.
We're not talking about his childhood, though. Like, nobody's talking about, like, when he was a little kid. We didn't take him, drop him off at school. We didn't pack his lunches. That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about as a man.
Right now, more so, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're more of a family than his father. We treat him as an equal. We treat him like he should be treated. Like, hey, you become a star. This is for you. Instead of... hey, follow me around while I do my thing and I continue all the praise and all the lights and the glamour and all that. And you could just be in my background. No, he's not a background to us. We stand all in a straight line.
Equal. It's equal. I understand that. Finn, up until July, you had never stepped in a ring one-on-one with Rey Mysterio. You're two of the all-time greatest. I know there's obviously a lot of personal animosity, as we've seen over the last few months. But when you stepped in there and looked across the ring for him for the first time, was there any reverence?
You know what? You're wrong. I did step in the ring with Ray before.
Okay.
The year I'm unsure of.
Okay.
It was the Royal Rumble where I lasted like 59 minutes.
That's right.
That was the person who actually threw Rey Mysterio's little pathetic ass over the top rope.
This was one-on-one, though. This was different.
Okay,
this was your focus. Yes. Yeah. But is there any reverence there? Can you appreciate stepping in there with him for the very first time in such a setting?
Oh, without question. I appreciate stepping in the ring with anyone for the first time. And, you know, Ray's career speaks for itself, someone who I've admired and respected for a long time. Whether that respect is going to continue to be there, given recent events, I'm unsure of. But, you know, you can never underestimate your competitor, and Ray has been around this business for so long that, you know, you can never underestimate someone who has that type of experience and legacy.
You know, I would say you're absolutely right. You can't underestimate someone who does have that kind of a legacy. And I would be remiss if I didn't bring up the fact that you yourself have a very similar legacy, albeit, you know, maybe a little bit later on generational-wise. So it's not, in my opinion, out of character for you at all to go in there wanting to prove yourself and looking at Rey Mysterio more as like an equal as opposed to someone who is, you know, a legend in his own right. You have that same kind of appeal to yourself and a legacy ahead of you, too. And you know this. And I don't think that's ever been lost on you. So, nice to hear the humility, but I don't quite buy it. I think you yourself deserve that kind of a respect. And, you know, you don't have to be so humble about talking about your first interactions with Rey Mysterio. I think from the get-go, you wanted to prove yourself, and I think it's been, you know, well-earned.
Well-earned. Make friends again?
Yeah, it felt like that.
Hey.
But while
I said I call it like I see it. No. I call it like I see it down the middle. I'm not afraid.
You know what? I redact my statement. I actually like being on here.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Well, and, you know, this is the third time I've been on the third, right?
Third time.
And the first two were via the internet.
Yep.
And then this is the first time in person.
In Stanford.
And I was adamant that I never wanted to come back on the show after the first time.
Right. Yeah.
Somehow I got roped into the second time.
Right.
And then the only reason I'm here for the third time is to back up my colleagues here. in the Judgment Day, you know, because where they go, I go. Obviously, Dom is absence, but, you know, we have to respect that.
Very understood.
Absolutely.
And, you know what? There's a slight possibility that I might come back in the year 2025 right. or something.
2025. Like we'll see you in a couple of years. Earlier, before you came on, we saw Drew break down possibly the most brutal coup de grace you've ever hit on last week's Monday Night Raw. It then got reported right here on this very show. As a result of that, a grade 2 MCL sprain. As we watch it again, as beautiful as it looks for you, how do you feel about the damage that you caused to the Hall of Fame?
I'm actually surprised it didn't cause more damage, to be honest with you.
Were you hoping to cause more?
A grade 2 sprain to an MCL?
Yes.
I've done a lot worse, to be honest.
You have.
So, if he can stand up anytime soon and wants to drag himself back to Raw, which I don't think that's going to be in the next couple of months, you know, we can improve on the damage.
There's more meat on the bone, you're saying.
There's plenty more.
Yeah.
You three enjoyed that greatly. As you've said, the Judgment Day is all about fun. Nothing more fun than getting four questions from the WWE Universe from a segment we call The Fan Four. Hit the graphic. Let's do it. There's a fun animation. It's a thing. Oh, there it is.
Hey.
Love it every time. All right.
This is exciting.
Rhea, let's kick it to you first. Your new theme, Demon in Your Dreams, hit music streaming services on Monday, featuring vocals from Chris Motionless. We have a question here from Kayla, not Braxton. She's not here today. It's a bummer. But Kayla asks, Rhea, how excited are you that Motionless and White are behind your newest entrance theme, and when can we possibly expect a live performance?
I am so extremely excited. Motionless and White, my all-time favorite band. I absolutely love them. I think Chris is amazing. His vocals are insane. How we ended up getting it to be a thing, I'm just so lucky for. I'm hoping that we get a live performance. I'm not sure when. I gotta start doing matches again, you know? And then hopefully we can have one soon. But I don't know how we're all gonna fit on stage because these boys are gonna be there with me.
Oh, that's awesome. Available on streaming services now. Let's switch gears again. We've talked a lot about these two, and Novel wants to know, what do you guys do for fun together when you're not beating up Ray or Edge? What's the family activities like when you're not beating those two gentlemen up?
Me and Priest like to watch Instagram reels together. Oh. Normally of people getting hurt, falling over, falling downstairs, people walk into glass. I like
They're
those ones
best.
Too.
Do you get ideas from that? Any ideas for your destruction?
You take ideas from
more anything. Ideas to beat up Ray and Edge from the Instagram.
There you go.
It's a full circle.
I didn't expect that.
Yeah, that's great. Damien, here's one. We got this a few times over. Any chances of Bad Bunny joining the Judgment Day? RCS88 wants to know, Damien.
Yeah, you know, I think we mentioned it before. You know, our doors are open. You know, if you're willing to want to make a change for yourself, and obviously he's extremely successful, one of the most popular humans on the planet.
Definitely.
But you could always be more. You could always strive for more. And that's what the Judgment Day is. So if Bad Bunny wants a spot, our door's open for him.
I would love to hear a Bad Bunny cover of the entrance music. Personally.
Ooh.
Yeah.
That's
a good idea.
That
might be the smartest thing you've said today.
Wow. Only took 48 minutes. Good job.
Well, there you go. Look at that. Well, we're in agreement here.
Bad Bunny or others could possibly be an addition to the group. Finn, you've had an addition to your wardrobe. The bad guy wants to know how the bandana look happened to come about. A lot of bandana talk, Finn. I got to tell you. More questions about the bandana than anything else.
I made a promise to myself and my dignity that I would not discuss or humor any of these fun jokes you guys have about the bandana. It was a spontaneous moment, and I'm sure it will live on in the future.
I mean, here we go. You did post about it. I just want to note that. Can we do this? Is this a thing?
You guys can do it. Yeah.
We could do it, right? Like, we have power now because of this, or is it the color wrong, or?
I gotta tell you, Finn, you're not gonna be able to get in certain malls wearing this outfit, and I think you've made your peace with that.
What's yours, a Deadpool one or something?
Yeah. I just grabbed one out of my house.
I got like a Springsteen thing going here on mine, I think, yeah. Yeah. This will work? No. So,
oh my God.
This took on a different life last week in this very studio. We didn't have any shoes on.
I feel more relaxed now.
Okay, good.
I heard about the no shoes from KO.
Yeah,
our buddies, and he told me just kick the shoes off and put his feet up on the desk.
He did. Amazing. But we watched what you did to Edge with him and Johnny Gargano last week, and it spurned a whole different discussion.
Oh.
Let's take a look at that now. Here you go.
Yeah.
So obviously, Judgment Day has been on a tear. They recruited Dominic. Yep. Rhea Ripley has got, you know,
a hold of him.
Yeah, and Damian Priest and Finn. But I think that what we just saw from Monday was a whole new level of dominance. Also, I think what spurred it on is Finn had this bandana when he came to the ring.
The bandana. He did.
The purple bandana.
I heard about that.
Took him to a whole new level. And I think the viciousness he showed, you know, going after Edge's knee that
like
way.
Like a prison Mike kind of scenario.
Yeah, very Michael Scott. Yeah, but man, I would, clearly when Finn's got that bandana on, you don't want any peace.
Is there power?
It's a good idea that I don't put the bandana on right now, right?
Absolutely. 100%. Is there power in it? Is there something to that?
I feel something.
You know where the power is?
You should feel ridiculous.
Power's in here, brother.
Power's in the brain. I should have known.
It ain't ridiculous.
You look ridiculous.
You got any, you want to ask about the bandana or any other great questions you have to?
I mean, I want to know which Pirates of the Caribbean movie you were watching when you were like, hey, that's a good idea. Uh-huh. You know? Yeah.
10 minutes. Can you last 10 minutes? We have 10 minutes left in the show.
I'm genuinely curious,
it's
man.
It's going to be hard for me.
Yeah, were you playing a pirate video game?
I understand. I completely understand at this point.
You did kind of the eye patch one like this.
Oh,
I thought it was really cool. It's going to be a hit
for
Halloween.
I'm going to take this off now.
You know, the action
this is Finn's thing. This is Finn's thing. Okay,
I'm
thank
sure
you.
We can get an action figure with a bandana,
absolutely.
Maybe.
That's smart. You're really
there.
See,
we go.
Once again, Ryan knows. The brain. Yeah. The brain is so far ahead of everybody else, including Drew. Let's talk about Riddle. Last week's Raw, Riddle, as we said earlier, declined the new path. But Finn, first time ever on Raw, you two would face off. Only the second time in your career. You got to go back to War Games 3, 2019.
Yeah.
Another victory over him in tag team matches past Monday. We know Damian has Riddle coming up. Is he someone you've kind of put in your personal rearview mirror, or is there more to do with Matt Riddle?
I think there's a lot more to do with Matt Riddle. Someone who I've admired for a long time from afar. Like you said, we had that first match on TakeOver a couple years ago, which I was actually diagnosed with the flu the day of and somehow managed to squeak past him that day.
Did your Bret Hart moment
That was it, yeah. But I've been extremely impressed with his growth in the last couple of years. He's a general in the ring. He says it himself, he's a stallion. That's no lie. He's got all the tools to make it in this business for a long time. And whether it's standing face to face or shoulder to shoulder, we'll see.
Next week, it's face-to-face for Damian and Riddle. And as we talked about earlier, Damian, you guys go back a long way. Monster Factory coming up all that way. It'll be the first time you go one-on-one on Monday Night Raw. First time you've actually battled since an NXT live event. I don't know if you remember this, in 2020. You teamed with Finn against Riddle and Tommaso Ciampa. We don't have to wait much longer. 5 more days. It's
That's
you and Riddle.
Right.
Well, there you go. So that Judgment Day goes back a little bit.
No, I remember that. Yeah, but I forgot we'd worked them in a tag match.
Yeah, that was a while back. And, you know, some of our, the beginnings of, to your point, the Judgment Day goes back a long ways. We became, you know, buddies, you know, through competition.
Right.
You earn respect, through respect, you form a bond. And with Finn Balor and I, that's exactly what happened. And that was kind of the first time, that was the first time we teamed. And we said it that night, it's like, man, that felt right. You know, and
that just happens sometimes, right? It's a very organic thing.
Yeah.
And even myself and Priest had the match at, I think it was a TakeOver.
In your house.
In your house.
That's a big one.
And, you know, obviously I was very familiar with his work, but we never kind of spent too much time together or obviously no time in the ring against each other. And that was the first time we'd ever touched. And it was kind of like in the moments after that match that, like, we kind of started to develop this bond that we have now.
You've talked about that match a lot, and kind of that sent you, maybe that was a fork of the road for your own career, because I feel like it sent you on a different path. Did you know Finn right there? Did you have a pre-existing opinion of Damian, and how did it change after that match?
The opinion I've had is, like, this guy, he's got a cool look. He's incredibly physically impressive. He knows what he's doing in the ring. He's experienced. And it was just a matter of really getting to know him on a personal level, which we got to do after that match at NXT In Your House. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of been a snowball effect since then.
Worked out quite nice.
Yeah.
I will say the last several weeks watching you guys, I've known, you know, the two of you for a pretty long time, you very long, and throughout your development, pretty long time. And the amount of confidence you guys have just stepped up is very glaring, in my opinion. And I feel like you guys feel it too, but I need to bring up a point, which is a testament to you as a mentor. So that is that's just another tip of the hat to you, so to speak. And with Rhea specifically, compare yourself to like a year ago, right? How do you feel like you have improved specifically since that time?
Oh, immensely. I feel like the main thing that's changed is my mental stability.
Yeah.
I'm definitely more confident in myself. I know what I want, and it's the same as what these boys want, and that's why we're all on the same page. We don't really care who we have to go through to get to it. If you're on our side, you're on our side. That's cool. If you're not, well, we're going to go through you. And that's the mentality that I have now, and I think that's why I've changed so much.
Yeah, it's very obvious. Cool. And I think that Finn has brought a lot of that out in you, if I may say so as well.
Absolutely.
Rhea, speaking of people that you may potentially face off with, go through, you and Beth Phoenix very well may be on a collision course here. There's been a lot of scuttlebutt in the ring real quick. There's been, she stole your shoes. That was a thing on Twitter. And then ultimately, you know, this has been the most recent interaction. You know where I am every Monday. That was directed to Beth Phoenix. You've talked about how much Beth meant to your career, but now, it could be locking horns. How badly do you want that fight potentially at some point?
I mean, I say it all the time. Beth Phoenix is my dream opponent. Growing up, watching her, I thought she was absolutely incredible. She's someone that I idolized and I really looked up to, being a bigger girl, having a different frame to everyone else. So I'm very excited. I hope that something does happen. I hope that she shows that she has a pair, and she's the one that wears the pants in her relationship, and she comes back to Monday night. Ready. Because I'm ready.
She doesn't have to pull those pants over a knee brace right now because of Finn, so there is that. Shifting gears a little bit, Damien, as we celebrate Hispanic Heritage Month, you have been a wonderful representative both inside and outside of the ring of your Puerto Rican heritage and culture. How has it been to be in such a major position with this platform?
Well, since you brought it up, the first thing I want to say is to everybody on the island, you know, stay well, stay safe. We hear you, we see you, and, you know, help is coming, and we're here in any way, shape, or form that we can help too. So, para ustedes, junto siempre. As an ambassador or whatever you want to call it, it's funny because the dream was this, being a superstar. Mm-hmm. You know, having an entrance, having moments, you know, WrestleMania and titles, and you forget about the other side, the impact you're going to have on people. And for me, the Hispanic culture. And one of my favorite things in the world is when somebody comes up to me and they say, hey, thank you for representing. Nothing to do with anything else other than thank you for representing. Thank you for mentioning your roots. Thank you for being a representative of our culture and educating. And that's my biggest thing is, like, you know, it's one race, we're a human race.
Right.
So we can learn from each other, you know, it doesn't matter where you were born, what color, ethnicity, anything. If you don't know something and somebody's representing in their own way, whether it's a shirt, a flag or whatnot, it's very easy to say, hey, where's that? Mm. What does that mean? And then now you just got educated on something. I'm very, very in tune with, like, and I always try to promote that to people, like, hey, really be proud of where you come from, you know. And as a Latino, obviously, it's, you know, in the entertainment business,
right?
You know, I feel like in 2022 everything is welcome now, and it's awesome,
and you're a big part of that. And I think you all three of you deserve credit for being able to represent so many different things, and we thank you so much.
I got this actually. Thank you so much for being here on the bump.
We have other things to do. Listen. Before we go,
before we
want to tell everyone not to miss out
not to miss out
on the action this holiday season, because 25 brand new events take place this fall, are available this Friday. Just for tuning in to The Bump today, you can get exclusive access to tickets before the general public. Just head to WWE.com/tickets, find your event, use the passcode THEBUMP, THEBUMP. WWE tickets also make it an amazing holiday gift. Don't miss out and grab your tickets now. By the way, we also want to send a shout out, because today Triple H and WWE presented this title to the WNBA champion Las Vegas Aces, who won the franchise's first WNBA title over the Connecticut Sun in 4 games. Congrats to Coach Becky Hammond, all the players, and there you go. You get that, and maybe Rhea will have one of those in the future. We thank the Judgment Day.
There you go.
Drew, I don't know what's going to happen to you after the show, but thank you to our guests. We appreciate that. We'll see you guys next week, everybody. Judgment Day is great. Drew did an okay job.
Guys, good job. Thank you so much.